we get into something that a lot of us love, but sometimes there's a lot of discussion on. The other big topic of discussion, it seems these days, is docks. So tell me, how can I get a private dock in Kawartha Lakes?
So we get a couple of nice days of weather and you want to talk about docks. So
yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
fair enough. I get it. It's coming up fast. So last term of council, the last council chose to put a policy in place, docks on municipal property. So there are some cottages and homes around the city, only in certain areas. But we have a lot of lakes and rivers where, you know, properties are on one side of the road and the other side of the road is the road allowance. And residents want to put docks or have been putting docks, some in some cases for many, many years, on the road allowance, you know, which is not really their property, it's the city's property. And they put docks there and they've been able to enjoy them, you know, enjoy water access. And same with some backlot owners, wherever there's space, you know, they've come down at some point and they've put a dock in, you know, on municipal property. So council needed to address this at some point. I mean, there is a liability. Obviously, if you have a dock on city property, then the city is assuming some of that liability if something happens. So last term of council, our legal team came forward and made some recommendations on a couple of recommendations. We could either have all docks removed on municipal property because they're not theoretically allowed to be there, or council could choose to put a licensing practice in place so that, you know, people have to have the proper insurance, they have to maintain their dock, and they have to be kept in a safe, you know, away from the road and away from the road allowance to allow proper maintenance on our roads. So council chose the latter. You know, we didn't want to sort of remove all these docks in our community. Some municipalities did. They passed resolution to any dock on municipal property is not allowed to be there. If you don't own the property, you can't have a dock. So we took, you know, a little less, and it created some controversy, obviously, because some people had docks for 30, 40, 50, 100 years that they've been utilizing, and we've asked that they be licensed. So staff are taking one section of the city at a time, and they're working away around our many lakes and rivers. And they're, you know, they're targeting these areas that some are really congested, like in Thurstonia. There's a lot of docks on top of each other. You know, a lot of backlot owners have property. And it's important to realize that if somebody doesn't have proper insurance on a dock on city property, and there's an accident or something happens, then the city and the rest of the taxpayers, the rest of our residents are liable for that, you know, from an insurance perspective. So we're not trying to say you can't have a dock. We're just saying if you choose to put a dock on municipal property, you know, you're going to have proof of insurance. You're going to have to pay a license fee because, you know, our staff have to do the paperwork and, you know, we're going to recover a little bit of that cost. And you will then have access, a license to have a dock on municipal property that, you know, you can carry that license forward if you sell your property. You know, the new owner can apply for a license as well. And what it does is it gives you exclusive use to that dock. Right now, if you have a dock on municipal property without a license, you may not realize this, but anybody can use that dock and it's not yours. It's not your property. So you can't kick them off. And I know people say, oh, they wouldn't stay on my dock, but theoretically, you know, anybody could come from anywhere in the province, go on the end of your dock. And because you don't have a license and it's not on your property, you're not allowed to have them removed. So we're just trying to clean it up a little bit. And, you know, it's created some controversy because some people have enjoyed these docks at no cost on municipal property for many, many years. And I understand that. But I think it's important to realize that we're not trying to remove everybody's dock. We're just trying to clean them up, you know, make sure people have a proper license. And most people understand the need to do this because the other option was to have everybody's dock removed and we didn't really want to go there. So we have quite a few of these docks around the municipality because we have, as you know, over 250 lakes and rivers. So it's going to take a few years and council's just sort of working their way through the process and that's what we're doing now. So that's why you're hearing about some of the back and forth about docks.